Hi everybody, I'm Brianna Bach and this is my GT project. For the project, I decided to go for a genetic algorithm because I'm interested in computer science and biology. And the genetic algorithm involves both of these. You might be wondering, what is a genetic algorithm? Well, genetic algorithms, otherwise known as GAs, are search-based optimization techniques based on Charles Darwin's principles of natural selection. Natural selection is a process through which populations of living organisms adapt and change. Individuals in a population are all different in some ways and have their own unique set of traits. The traits better suited for survival and reproduction are the ones that tend to become more common in organisms. There are many applications for the algorithm, including usage in research and machine learning to find solutions to difficult problems. The code allows solutions to be found when it might take too long to solve for other techniques. Now let's get into the actual code. How does it work? First, we estimate the initial population. We start with a best guess as to an initial starting point, representing the estimate of individuals in a population who seem fit. Then, we use a fitness function to determine how fit an individual is. A fitness score can be calculated for each successive generation or iteration. Next, the fittest individuals are selected to pass on their genes to the next generation. Crossover is the fourth step. This combines genes from two parents to form children for the next generation. Fifth is mutation, which applies random changes to individual parents to form children. In the code, we will repeat the second through fifth steps until an acceptable solution is obtained. And there we have it, the genetic algorithm. How about an example problem? Cracking the combination of a safe is one application of the genetic algorithm. The combination of the safe consists of digits ranging from 0 to 9, applied in the exact order. The program will generate an initial sequence at random, compare it to the actual combination, and grade the result based on the number of matches. In the real world, you could imagine using a sound detector clamped to the door of the safe to detect the number of matches. You then change one value in your solution, aka mutation, and compare again. If another match is found, you throw away the old sequence and move forward with the new one, otherwise known as selection. Else, you continue with the old sequence. Here is the data comparison of runtime for brute force and the genetic algorithm. It is interesting to have an idea of how long and how many tries it takes to solve the problem using a brute force approach compared to the genetic algorithm. Whereas brute force works through all the possible combinations, the genetic algorithm is more efficient, as shown by the table. I found three programs on the web and ran them to get data on runtimes. These three programs all generate all possible combinations that could occur for the given number of digits in the combination. Here's the data for the different combination lengths, or values of n, compared to the runtime it took for the genetic algorithm I programmed in Java. You can see that the brute force method takes much longer as the n increases, even crashing due to exceeding the maximum memory or due to time. However, the genetic algorithm does not have this problem. Now let's take a look at the code. The main program at the bottom is used to call the main method crackit, as well as time how long it takes to run the program from start to finish. The crackit method will first accept the correct combination from the user, then start the process with a random starting combination value. In this case, we use all zeros. On line 6, we see the Java fitness method, which is used to grade each new attempt, comparing each iteration of the genetic algorithm to the actual combination value. Lines 44 and 45 select a random spot to modify and select a random value from 0 to 9 for that spot. This represents random mutation. Finally, the fitness grade is determined on line 48, representing natural selection, and on line 51, we choose the new attempt if it has a better fitness score, which is the computer version of crossing over genetic material. Let's run the code. This is what we get here at the bottom. You could actually run the program entering 10 digits, and it will run in less than 10 seconds.